Hey everybody, Julie G, a little update from the road. I am in Columbia, Missouri, getting ready to shoot the NRIB Yankee Cup. Oh, this is an awesome match. It's one of the most enduring action pistol matches in the world. I think we're going on 30 years or something, I'm not even sure. But it's definitely been around for a while. I believe the first Yankee Cup was held in 1979. And it's one of those events where you definitely want to be one of the people who bring home one of those beautiful silver cups. And so everyone makes the pilgrimage every year to Columbia, Missouri, to the Green Valley Rifle and Pistol Club to shoot this event. And it's a tough one. It's probably one of the most difficult matches I shoot in the year because, unlike most other action shooting sports, there is a perfect score. The perfect score is 19-20. It's 192 shots. And, of course, you have 192 X's available, too. I want every one of them. but it's a great, great event. You have the plates, practical, mover, and barricade. And what's really cool about this particular event, the Bianchi Cup, is that in addition to having the match that's starting on Wednesday, not very far down the road is the Green Valley Rifle and Pistol Club second range, and they have all of the stages set up for you to practice. And so lots of ammo gets shipped in to hotels, and everybody spends a lot of time at the range, and it's really cool because you get to hang out with shooters, which is always fun, and I certainly enjoy that, but you also get to shoot pretty much from 8 a.m. till 8 p.m. as long as you want. I got in yesterday afternoon here into Columbia and started practicing, and I'm all geared up, as you can see. I just got back from a match. The Flagler Cup is in Kansas City, and that was this morning. So I got up at early wake up at 4:45 a.m. and drove the 2 hours to Bates City near Kansas City and shot that match. Have some bugs I need to work out. but one thing that I am trying to do this year is I'm trying to get some warm-up matches in. It seems like for the past few years, well, since moving to Montana, it's been really difficult for me to get some good warm-up in. It seems like every time I head out the door, a national or world title's at stake, so that's that can be a little nerve-wracking. So for the single-stack nationals, I shot the Area 1 championships, got to work out all the little glitches in my game, and of course had a very good match at the single-stack nationals a couple weeks ago. And kind of along the same lines, I wanted to make sure that I got some sort of event in to kind of get, you know, juiced up and feel the pressure of what it's like to shoot these horses of fire with that added, you know, match pressure. So there I went, pew, this morning to near Kansas City, and I shot not a very good score, I'll be honest, but I was happy with the barricade and the plates because I was a little nerved up and have some bugs to work out on my mover and my practical. So that's really good because I have today, the rest of today, Monday and Tuesday to really focus in on those things and, of course, you know, get ready to go. So I am actually going to change my shirt into a little t-shirt and head out to the practice range and see a bunch of shooters there and get some rounds downrange. So hopefully this week some of the updates that some of you have asked me through email, Twitter, Facebook, yada yada, from the road, is what kind of gear I use for each of my events. So I'm going to go over my Bianchi gun for you in my next update, and also my new awesome Safariland holster. And I know what you're thinking, it's just a holster, but this thing is totally, totally awesome because I have four different Bianchi guns, and they're all a little bit different, and this holster is awesome. So anyway, I won't give all that information away. But I hope everyone's having a great weekend, and stay tuned for the next On the Road update.